Welcome to St. Michael's service in these lockdown times. We have to worship at home, socially distanced, to keep each other safe. But God calls us, come and see. So welcome to church. Not really a place, but an invitation. Not a building, but a way of engaging. Not a service, but a way of serving. Not an institution, but a path to adventure. In this time and space, let us gather and welcome each other, decide to love more, and break the rules of the world with the generosity of the kingdom. And if anyone asks why, or how, or what does it all mean, simply use Jesus' words, come and see. Let us worship God, and let us pray.
Dare we, O God, to be here in the mystery we do not fully understand? Dare we, O God, to seek here the truth we cannot grasp? Dare we, O God, to speak here of the one who dares stir life in us? And among all the questions we have, the wonder and confusion, may we dare to come and see what the kingdom is like. Come and see the shape of living words. Come and see the water that pours with new life. Come and see the bread that is broken for the world. Come and see the people who believe in hope. Come and see the one who speaks of justice. Come and see the place where heaven meets earth. Come and see the one who has called us by name. In all the wonder and mystery, in the confusion and questions, may we find a place of faith that forgets the ready answers and seeks a new adventure yet unformed, free of ancient traditions and fresh for the world as it is now, in this time and for this place. Loving God, may we be here with hearts that are open, ready to know the wonder that is your presence among us. This we pray as we pray the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
O God, you search me and you know me. All my thoughts lie open to your gaze. When I walk or lie down, you are before me, ever the maker and keeper of my days. You know my resting and my rising. You discern my purpose from afar. And with love everlasting you beseech me, in every moment of life or death you are. Before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you have known its meaning through and through. You are with me beyond my understanding, God of my present, my past and future too. Although your Spirit is upon me, still I search for shelter from your light. There is nowhere on earth I can escape you, even the darkness is radiant in your sight. For you created me and shaped me, gave me life within my mother's womb. For the wonder of whom I am, I praise you. Safe in your hands, all creation is made new.
Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim, so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go, lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Thanks be to God.
Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael there and said to him, "We have found him, about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip replied, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, "He is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you come to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you over." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A few years ago, I spoke to someone who had lived and worked all over the world, And in his professional life, he had advised countries about how to communicate with other nations and the world media. I said, "So you were helping them to say the right thing?" And he replied, "Well, actually, to listen to each other." After the terrible events on the 11th of September 2001, political powers declared war on terror. In the midst of shock and the horror of the situation, action called forth reaction. However, don't you think it would have been much better if the world had stopped and grieved and then asked, why do people feel they have to do this? How much better it would have been if people had spent time listening to the stories, grievances, hurts, the despair driving fanaticism and terrorism, making desperate people choose death as the only way forward. 20 years later, we can tell of many more atrocities, racism in communities and institutions, alienation and distrust, unbearable divisions between rich and poor in the world, the climate now changing because of our ways of living, driving mass migrations, the extinction of species threatening because we are still growing the economy, producing and using stuff rather than treasuring resources and living sustainably. The danger is that we are spiraling into deeper and deeper trouble for the whole world unless we listen to others in a shrinking world. Greed for wealth or power can make us blind towards the needs of others, even those very close to us. Exploitation, enslavement, and oppression are the result, and placing us far from kingdom ways. Our Old Testament story gives a warning example. Eli, the priest, had watched his sons grow and thrive. Imagine the proud father seeing his sons follow in his footsteps. At first, they maybe took just a little for themselves, a just reward. As things get worse, Eli tries to rebuke them. Was he not forceful enough? They do not listen. What could Eli do? And then the boy Samuel is called by God, and judgment is given on Eli and his sons. Samuel grows up in a night from apprentice to prophet, and Eli accepts the ruling of the Lord his God. He listened. Samuel was able to hear the voice of God, but he did not hear an easy message. Eli, going blind and maybe also blinded by the way things were, was unable to hear the voice of God, but in realizing what is happening, listens, accepts the judgment. When we hear the Bible stories, do we just hear it, hear them, or can we listen? Now, listening is not the same as hearing. Hearing refers to the sounds that you hear, whereas listening to another person requires more than that, requires focus. Listening means paying attention not only to the words and the story, but how it is told, the use of language and voice, and how the other person uses his or her body. In other words, it means being aware of both verbal and non-verbal messages. Your ability to listen effectively depends on the degree to which you perceive and understand these messages. A man once sought advice as his marriage was in trouble. "What shall I do, master?" he asked of a wise man. The master said, "You must learn to listen to your wife." The man took his advice to heart and returned after a month to say that he had learned to listen to every word his wife was saying. The master said with a smile, Now go. Go home and listen to every word she is not saying. Can we ordinary people of this time and age learn to listen better to each other? Of course we can. And our relationships will improve if we do so. Can we also become better listeners to God's voice and will? Yes, indeed. And we do not have to become great visionaries or mystics to do so. We come to worship on Sundays or any time, but we do this in preparation of the days to come. We come to see love practiced as we meet in normal times, as we meet with people unrelated to us of different ages and stages and backgrounds, known and loved by God and made into brothers and sisters, into God's family, gathered with us around his word and table. Then, in the following days, the world is the arena of our discipleship. We are called not just to hear big words and old stories on Sundays, but called to listen through them for the voice of God, and then to go and put God's love into action, using all of ourselves, body and soul. The German theologian Helmut Thielicke once wrote, "At the beginning of the war, I stood in the bell tower of St. Catherine's Church in Danzig with a church organist. He sat down at the keyboard of the carillon to play a hymn on the hour. His mighty proclamation of the gospel rang out over the whole town. The bells beat upon my ears, and the sound of their message so filled me that no other sound could intervene. Far below, though, I could see people going on with their business. They were building an air raid shelter. The excavators cluttered, the pneumatic drills hammered away, and traffic surged along. No one looked up to listen to the music that was pounding in my ears and filling me to the brim. What sounded all around us up above remained inaudible down there below amidst the noise of daily work. Have we heard the sound that comes from above? We certainly cannot stop our machines, nor should we try. But we can pay attention to the sound that filters through our earthly noise. For the air is full of promises, and we would lose everything if we failed to hear them." When Jesus was about 30 years old, Roman armies had occupied the land, and Israel is despondent. Is God still with them? Will God not send a messenger, his anointed, the Messiah? Nathanael is one of many of his time hoping for God's revelation, most likely in the form of violent interference. Then his brother Philip arrives in high excitement. He has news of the Messiah. But from Nazareth? Nathanael is not impressed at the news his brother Philip brings. Should he listen to him? Grudgingly, he follows to see what the fuss is all about. And in listening to Jesus and his insight into him, though meeting for the first time, he becomes convinced that here is not just any old man from Nazareth, but more than Philip had expected and promised, the Son of God, the King of Israel. Nathanael, like his brother Philip, follow Jesus from then on to become witnesses of greater things and see Jesus linking heaven and earth. God has come to interfere, but not with violent, vengeful actions, but by coming in vulnerable humility to teach the world a new way through the Prince of Peace. Our world is full of fear, noise and discord and disease. The pandemic forces us apart, threatens lives, mental health, education, the arts, the economy, and so much more. Yet people still have to deal with other diseases, prejudice and disadvantage, war and terror, and the changing climate. What do we hear when we listen for the voice of God through the cacophony of world events, full of sickness, murder, hatred, and mayhem? Blessed are the peacemakers. Blessed are the humble and the pure in heart. Blessed are the persecuted and the grieving. Blessed are the merciful and those hungry for righteousness. Blessed are those who are poor in spirit and not full of themselves. For those who listen to God have a chance to see, like Jacob in a dream, God's angels descending and ascending on a ladder, connecting heaven and earth. Those who listen to God have a friend in Jesus, the link between heaven and earth, the ways of the world and the ways of God's kingdom, bringing new life with new ways. So when the noise of life threatens to deafen your hearing, stop, take a deep breath, and listen for the good news still coming to us from God, who loves each one of us and sends us on the road to love like him. Listen, and then go to love the loveless. Amen.
Thank you.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Creator God, we thank you for the invitation to new possibilities, the invitation to us and all who are hungry or hurt to open up. May we all come and see where the kingdom is made in the sharing of gifts, the finding of the lost, and the welcoming of the stranger. May this be done through our own response, our gifts and giving, blessed by you and for the glory of your name. Amen. Thank you for all you do to share the kingdom with each other and support the work of the church. Now let us pray for others and for ourselves. Loving God, we have come and we try to see your ways, to learn your love. We have come to hear and listen to your voice, calling us and others to learn and live your ways between our neighbours, in the love we share, between our nations, in the compassion we offer, between all people, in the peace we make. Lord, help us to grow and to grow your kingdom among us. And so we pray for others who cannot come or cannot hear. We pray for those in conflict, for the homeless, refugees, and the displaced, for so many who suffer from disease, hunger, fear, or division. Lord of love and peace, teach us and others to live in your way. We pray for our governments, for Westminster and Edinburgh, for Brussels and Washington, Moscow and Beijing, and the longing to find stability and a future that is balanced and fair, equally shared and kingdom-shaped. We pray for our congregation and parish, for our neighbours around us and the way we live and speak together of love, grace and truth. We pray for our families and friends, for those ill and those recovering, for all working in hospitals or the community during this pandemic, for those grieving and hurting, those anxious and worried, fearful and afraid. Lord, give strength and comfort on all ways. May your love direct us, call and challenge us to be your people, to see your kingdom between us, among us, and established through us. All this we ask in Jesus' name, to whom be all glory and honour, with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore. Amen.
Jesus calls us here to meet him as through word and song and prayer. We affirm God's promised presence where his people live and care. Praise the God who keeps his promise. Praise the Son who calls us friends. Praise the Spirit who among us to our hopes and fears attends.
Jesus calls us to confess him, word of life and Lord of all, shed off our flesh and frail, saving all who fail upon. Tell his holy human story, tell his tales that all may hear. Tell the world that Christ in glory came to earth to meet us here.
Jesus calls us to each other, vastly different though we are. Creed and colour, class and gender, neither limit nor debar. Join the hand of friend and stranger, join the hands of age and youth. Join the faithful and the doubter in a common search for truth.
Today we came and saw. Today, tomorrow, and always, may we go in peace to love and to serve with the blessing of God Almighty, of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.